Good morning and welcome to our all-age service. I'm Vicky, the Children and Families Worker here.
And I'm Lahna, I'm the Youth and Young Adults Worker.
And we're so excited that you can join us this morning.
We don't know what kind of week you've had. You might be watching this on Sunday morning and you've had a stressful week or a stressful start to your day. Or it might be that you're watching this not on a Sunday, you're catching up some other time. And so we just want to, before we start with some worship, we just want to get ourselves into the right headspace, the right frame of mind to come and worship our God. So why don't we just take a moment to still ourselves and to pray. Lord God, we thank you for this opportunity to gather together wherever we are in our different homes, but still as a community. And we just want to remind ourselves of who you are. Help us to draw close to you in this time. Remind us, God, of who you are and of who we are. We love you. We worship you. Be with us this morning. Help us to put any stresses or anxieties away so that we can just draw close to you in this time. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Why don't we worship together?
Stand before. Oh, bonus, oh, we made
Thanks, guys, for the worship. So, Lahna, how are you?
I'm okay. My nerves have slowly come back from last Friday night. I'm not going to lie. It was a terrifying experience, but I'm feeling okay.
You seem a bit better, but well, you're better than Friday. So, last Friday, Lahna and I had a movie night. We watched a film. It was brilliant. Lahna was a little bit scared.
It was terrifying. Vicky, I'm nervous. Where's Coral? Vicky, I hate this. Scared.
Somewhere beyond the sea.
Just find a new mate. It's a classic.
My lover stands on golden sands and watches the ships.
So how about finding Dory?
No, absolutely not. Do you know what though? I feel like now I could re-watch Finding Nemo because here's the thing. Now I know how it ends. I know that Bruce is a good guy. I know that they find Nemo. Spoiler alert, sorry. But I feel like now I know how it ends, I feel like I could maybe watch it again and it wouldn't be so scary and it wouldn't be so terrifying.
I guess maybe that's a bit like life, isn't it? When we don't know what's around the corner or what the next challenge is, sometimes it can be hard to navigate that, and it'd be so much easier if we knew it all turned out okay in the end.
Exactly, I feel like things aren't so scary when like you know how it ends. And I think that's why hope is so important. Like now if I was to re-watch Finding Nemo, I could have hope when things are scary because I know how it's gonna end. And I think that's a bit like life, you know? Like we need that hope so that we know how things are gonna end to be able to get through challenging and difficult situations, whether that is doing exams and having hope that it's going to turn out all right, or whether it is going through a pandemic and having hope that there is light at the end of the tunnel. Like, we need that, don't we?
Or even eating spaghetti. I mean, when does that end?
Yeah, absolutely. So we wanted to speak to the church family and find out what is it that gives us hope and what is it that we are hoping for in the future.
Hello. We've been asked to talk about what we hope for, and we've come up with a silly one each and a serious one each. So we'll do our silly ones first. Jasmine, what's your silly one?
Hope that we win the Eurovision and get a car right.
How long? Well, how likely do you think we are to win Eurovision?
A bit more likely to come
second place. Second place, I think we're going to come last. My silly one is that Southend United get promoted back to the league next year, which is probably even less likely than winning Eurovision. And Jasmine, what's your serious one?
We hope that Harley will stay well with the school lots, because it's been really fun. Be able to be with him.
That's Jasmine's friend Harley from school, who's been poorly, and we pray for him. And my serious one, in my work, I work on Northern Ireland, and my hope and my prayer is that the communities in Northern Ireland will be at peace and will find friendship in the future.
There's a hamster between them, they'll be fine.
That's right. Say goodbye, Jasmine. Bye.
I think I hope for the future that families will be able to meet together again, will be able to come back to church, and just that we will really know that God's part of it and just reflect Him in everything we do. And that's my hope for the future.
I hope I can play the orange drunkard at the church. If I can.
I'm hoping that the church family gets back together and that we all meet up again. And that I can also meet up with my family again. I'm longing to be able to go to Australia and meet up with my daughter and family over there. So that's what I'm hoping for.
My hope is to see Jesus in real life.
I love that Jasmine's got hope that the UK are going to win the Eurovision.
Absolutely.
And that means a curry. And Joseph, wouldn't that be great to be able to play the drums again here in church? And I guess we're all hoping that one day we will see Jesus face to face. And you know what? The Bible has got a lot to say about hope. In Psalm 46, verses 1 to 3, we read this. God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth give way and the mountains fall into the heart of the sea. Though its waters roar and foam and the mountains quake with their surging.
And thousands of years later, you know, we read from Paul the same sort of thing. Like, we see this throughout the Bible. So actually in Romans chapter 8, it's my favorite chapter in the whole Bible. And in Romans chapter 8, Paul says, I consider that our present sufferings are not worth comparing with the glory that will be revealed in us. For the creation waits in eager expectation for the children of God to be revealed. For the creation was subjected to frustration, not by its own choice, but by the will of the one who subjected it, in hope that the creation itself will be liberated from its bondage to decay and brought into the freedom and glory of the children of God. We know that the whole creation has been groaning, as in pains of childbirth, right up to the present time. Not only so, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, groan inwardly as we wait eagerly for our adoption to sonship, the redemption of our bodies. For in this hope we are saved. But hope that is seen is no hope at all. Who hopes for what they already have? But if we hope for what we do not yet have, we wait for it patiently. I love that. I love what Paul has to say about hope. That hope is built on what we have not yet seen, and yet we have faith in and we believe in. And isn't that the message of our faith as Christians? That, you know, Paul writes, it's almost like he's writing in 2021. The whole creation has been groaning, as in the pains of childbirth. I don't know about you, but it feels like right now the whole earth is groaning. Whether that's climate change or the pandemic or poverty or injustice, or maybe for you, you have your own situation that just feels like is full of groaning. And yet we have hope because we have God. We have a God who loves us, a God who is present with us through his Spirit, a God who protects us, a God who provides for us. And so, even though we are still groaning with the pain of what is going on, we can have hope.
Absolutely. But having hope doesn't mean that we won't come across those challenging situations, that they won't be difficult at that time, especially if we don't know when they're going to end. But I think what we need to remind ourselves of in that time is that we do have hope. We need to trust in God. Perhaps we need to lean on him even more during those times and consciously be aware of his presence, to read his word, to pray, to know that there is an end, there will be an end, and that we can rely on him.
And so as a church, we want to declare together, it is finished. That doesn't mean that things aren't tough, it doesn't mean that things aren't painful, but we have hope as a community, and in that hope we declare, as Jesus did, it is finished. And so what we would love to do is to do an activity together to kind of reflect on that and to verbalize some of that. And so what we would love for you to do is to grab a piece of paper, an A4 piece of paper, plain paper if you've got it, and a pair of scissors. So if you're watching this live, you've got a few seconds now to go and get some paper and scissors. And if you are watching this after it's gone live, you could just pause the video. So go and grab yourself some paper and scissors.
Do you need a pen?
Oh, you will need a pen as well. Thanks, Vicky. Yes, you will need a pen as well. In fact, if you've got colouring pens and felt tips or crayons, go grab those. And if you are a child and you're watching this, maybe get a parent to help you with this next activity because you're going to be cutting paper. So that is what we are going to be doing. Let us show you what we are going to create together. Okay, so hopefully you have your paper, you have your scissors, and you have some pens to draw with. So what we are going to be creating is a booklet like this. So it's a little paper booklet, and you get to write your own story. So this is Lahna's story, and I wanted to read it with you, if that's okay. So it starts off, Lahna was really excited about youth work and all the big plans and dreams that she had. But then, in March, the coronavirus changed everything. I'm sure a lot of us are going to have something similar in our stories. The young people Lahna loved to work with couldn't meet in person, and Zoom soon got very boring. Lahna felt sad and nervous and angry. What was going to happen to the youth work now? This is kind of the big in the middle of the story. But then God reminded Lahna that he was still caring for the young people, even in the pandemic. And even though things still aren't completely normal, God has said that he will never leave us or forsake us or stop caring for us. And so it is finished. So what we're going to do together is we are going to create our own booklets, which we can then write our own stories in. And I would love for you to write your story. What is it that you are going through now? What may be a bit of a challenge or a difficult situation that you want hope in? And then you get to write the ending of that story. Now, if you want, you could write the ending that you want to happen, the thing that you're hoping for. Or you could write the thing that gives you hope, even if you don't know the ending. So what you're going to do is grab your piece of paper. You are going to fold it in half and fold along the middle line. You are then going to fold this in half again and fold along the line. And then you are going to fold it one more time. So it should look in the end, once you've folded it, like this. And so if you open your paper out, you should have 8 different rectangles. So if we fold it back together again, this way, you want to find where the bottom crease is, which is here, and you want to cut along this line here, where the crease is at the bottom. So you'll end up with your paper looking like this. And so what we're going to do is we're going to open it out, and now you can see that in the middle of your paper there is a hole, and so we are going to fold the paper where that hole is. And so what you should be able to do is do this. It almost looks like a little bit of a mouth, doesn't it? And so if you fold the paper like this, and if you gently press it together, it kind of comes together to create this almost like a star. And then, if you get an adult to help you maybe with this bit, you can fold those pages together, and then you create your own booklet.
I am so impressed, Lahna.
It's good, isn't it? All you need is one piece of paper and you can make a little booklet. So once you've made your booklet, you can start writing your story in it. And Vicky has written her own story. So do you want to read your story for us? I really want to know how yours ends.
So this is my story. Lahna helped me make the book. Vicky was really excited to go to college. Even better, it was back in her hometown where she grew up. She had many happy memories. Vicky met some great people. She learned lots about God, faith, and working with children. But all this changed when Vicky was asked to write about those experiences. She kept putting it off.
Oh, I know that one.
I'll do it tomorrow. Unsure that she could even write her name, panic set in. Deadlines loomed. How on earth would she finish this work? She was almost there. One last hurdle. But it seemed to be the hardest. But God said, don't give up. Be confident, you can get it done. And she knows that God has called her to this work. She knows that she's been in this situation before. And she knows without doubt that God will provide the time, the space, and even the words.
I love that. So we would love to hear what your stories are. So create your booklets, fill them with your stories of hope, the thing that, and the person that you hope in and what you are hoping for, because it is finished. We're gonna have time to pray now and to worship God. So why don't we make time to do that?
Thank you. Miracle worker,
Thank you so much to our amazing young people for leading us in worship.
If you're around next Sunday, the 23rd, we are celebrating Pentecost with pims and hymns in the car park. If you want to come along, please can you sign up on our website.
And if you're a young person or if you have a young person, we're going to be doing a whole bunch of different activities over the May half term, our first thing back in person. And then after the May half term, we're going to be starting some regular youth events. So get in touch with me if you want to find out more information, and I will give you everything that is going on.
So may the blessing of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, the one that gives you hope, be with you and your families now and forever. Amen.
Amen. See you later.